Hi everyone, welcome back to our channel. So far we are finding the Fourier series expansions of given functions on the open interval 0, 2π only. Now onwards, given interval is in the form of −π, π. Open interval −π, +π. Look at the example. Prove that x square is equal to π² / 3 + 4 × of summation n is equal to 1 to ∞ −1 n into cos nx by n square for −π is less than x is less than pi. This means that we have to prove the Fourier series representation of the function x square on the interval −π, +π is this one. And hence, see, one more question is given here. And hence, derive 1/1² −1/2² +1/3² −1/4² +1π² / 4. We have to prove this result by using Fourier series expansion of x square. Okay, see the solution. Let f of x is equal to given function x square defined on open interval −π, +π. Okay, see here, whenever given interval is in the form of −π, +π, you should remember one important formula on integrations. Integration of −c2 + c f of x dx is equal to, the value of this integration is directly 0 if the inside function f of x is odd. Okay, f of x is odd. If this function f of x is even, then what happened? You should write 2 in the product and make the lower limit −c2 0, and upper limit is similar upper limit f of x into dx. Okay, this formula is only when the inside function f of x is even. Don't forget this formula. This is very, very important thing. Okay, now the required Fourier series. The required Fourier series of f of x is, already we know that the formula for Fourier series is f of x is equal to a0/2 plus summation n is equal to 1 to ∞ an into cos nx plus sigma n is equal to 1 to ∞ bn into sin nx. Okay, take it equation number 1. Okay, so it is enough to find out the values of a0 and an and bn. After getting these values, we have to replace these all three values in this formula. So you will get the Fourier series representation of the given function f of x. So what is the formula for a0 here? 1/π integral −π/2 + π f of x dx. What is f of x? Given problem. So 1/π into integral −π/2 + π x square into dx. Okay, here don't take the integration blindly. Okay, don't take the integration. In general, integration of x square is x³/3, but don't write directly here. It is better to apply this formula here. We know that this x square is even. That's why, according to this formula, what happened? If a inside function is even, you should write 2 in the product and make the lower limit to 0. Upper limit is same, x² dx. So 1/π into 2 is nothing but 2/π. Now you can take the integration, because this method is very easy. Integration of x² is x³/3 within the limits 0 to π. So 2/π into, by apply upper limit, you will get π³/3 −0. 1π getting cancelled. So a0 value is 2π² by 3. From this, what is a0/2? In the first term, in the Fourier series expansion, first term is a0/2. That's why I am finding a0/2 here. 2 getting cancelled on both sides. We have to divide the entire this term with 2. So this 2 getting cancelled. So result is only π² by 3. Please highlight this value with your box. Now we have to find out the value of an. See, now an is equal to, the formula for an is 1/π integral −π 2 plus pi f of x into cos nx dx. f of x into cos nx dx. Replace the values. 1 by pi into integral minus pi to plus pi. What is f of x? Given function. It would be x square into cos nx dx. Don't apply UV rule here blindly. Okay. Don't take the integration directly. Because lower limit is minus pi. Okay. It is very difficult to apply lower limit minus pi after completion of the integration. So here limits are in the form of minus c to plus c. So whenever limits are in the form of minus c to plus c, you should remember this formula. Okay. So here we are observing that x square is even into product is there. And every cos function is also even. So what is the product of even into even? By using the properties of even and odd functions, product of two even functions is again even function. That's why use this second formula. Write 1, 2 in the outside of the integration. Already 1 by pi is there. So you will get 2 by pi and make the lower limit to 0. Upper limit is similar pi. X square into cos nx. In my opinion, this method is very easy. Okay. 2 by pi into apply UV rule now. Okay. In previous problems, in many times, we are using the UV rule. Please remember that formula. So, u into similar term. Integration of cos nx. Sin nx by n minus derivative for the first term is 2x. Integration of sin nx is minus cos nx by n. You should write the integration in brackets only by n, but already n is there, so you will get n square plus derivative of 2x is 2 only minus integration of cos nx is sin nx by n, but n square is there, you will get n cube. The next term is derivative of 2, which is 0, so UV formula is completed with this one within the limits 0 to pi. Now we have to apply the limits. Whenever we have x, we should replace it by pi. See. See, the next term becomes to 2 by pi whole into apply upper limit. What is upper limit? Pi. Whenever we have x, replace it by pi. So pi square into sin n pi. Already we know that sin n pi is 0. Don't forget this formula. And cos n pi is minus 1 whole power n. Please remember this both formula in this problem. So whenever we have sin n pi, blindly replace it by 0. So 0 into anything? 0. First term will be 0. Minus. Already one minus is there. So minus into minus plus. 2 into x. Again we have x here. Replace it by upper limit. So 2 pi into cos n pi. Cos n pi can be replaced by minus 1 whole power n. And denominator is n square. Again in the last term we have sin. Sin n pi is 0. By applying lower limit, which is 0. 0 into anything 0. 2 times of 0 is 0. Sin 0 is 0. By applying lower limit 0, all terms becomes 0. Okay. So 1 pi getting cancelled. So the value of an is equal to 2 to the 4 minus 1 whole power n. Okay. 4 into minus 1 whole power n by n square. This is the value of an. Now we have to calculate bn. What is bn value? The formula for bn is 1 by pi into integral minus pi to plus pi. Integral minus pi to plus pi f of x into sin nx dx. So 1 by pi into integration of minus pi to plus pi. What is the f of x? Given function, which is x square into sin nx dx. So here also don't apply UV rule blindly. Okay, whenever limits are in the form of minus c to plus c, immediately you should remember this formula. Here we are observing that already we know that x square is even function and every sine function is odd. Sine is always odd and cos is always even. Don't forget it. So product of even and to odd. Product of even and odd is odd. So the entire function inside the integration is odd. So according to that first rule, entire integration becomes zero. Without doing the integration, we should conclude the value of this integration is zero. That is the advantage of this formula. Okay. So a naught by 2 is pi square by 3. An value is this one and bn is 0. Replace these all values in 1. So you will get required Fourier series. What is it? So from equation number 1, f of x is nothing but x square. A naught by 2 is nothing but pi square by 3 plus summation n is equal to 1 to infinity. An is nothing but 4 times of minus 1 whole power n by n square into an into cos nx. But bn is 0, that's why I don't want to write the next term, because summation of 0 into sine is 0. That's why. So this is the required Fourier series. Since 4 is the constant, I will take outside from sigma. You can write here. So this is the given result. Now we have to derive the given deduction. See. Now text heading deduction. So in most of the cases we can get the given deduction by replacing x is equal to 0 in this Fourier series representation. So put x is equal to 0 in this one. So 0 square, because here we have left hand side is x square. So 0 square means 0, pi square by 3 plus summation n is equal to 1 to infinity. I think 4 is there in the outside. Yes, 4 into minus 1 whole power n by n square into cos 0. What is cos 0? Cos 0 is 1. Okay, it would be 1. Now take this term to left hand side, you will get minus pi square by 3 is equal to 4 times of sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity minus 1 whole power n by n square. Okay, divide with 4, otherwise you can take this 4 to this denominator, you will get minus pi square by 12, and expand this series. Expansion means replace n is equal to 1, you will get the first term, minus 1 whole power 1, it would be minus 1 by 1 square. Whenever we have n, replace it by 1 square, plus replace n is equal to minus 1 whole square, which is positive, 1 by 2 square. Now n is equal to 3. Okay, if n is odd, it would be negative. If n is even, then term becomes positive. Don't forget it. Minus 1 by 3 square plus 1 by 4 square minus 1. Now multiply with the negative sign on both sides. So you will get pi square by 12 is equal to minus of minus plus 1 by 1 square minus into positive negative plus 1 by 3 square minus 1 by 4 square plus 1. This is the required derivation. So in most cases, by replacing x is equal to 0, you will get this deduction. Thank you very much. In the next video, I will give some more problems on Fourier series.